Okay, good evening to everyone. In the last class, we discussed about what is CNC part programming and what is the definition for CNC part programming and what are the codes involved in doing a CNC part programming. Those are G codes, M codes, N codes, and XYZ, IJK codes. Next, FSTM. Those are the codes used for CNC part programming. Next, and what are the devices used for input given to the CNC part programming? That means program input device. Next, machine control unit. Previously, I was told you what is machine control unit. It is the heart of CNC part programming system. Okay, next, today in this class, we will do a sum problem like on milling operation by taking CNC part programming as the example for milling operation. Okay. It is in the subject of CAD/CAM unit 3 in CNC part programming. Okay, in this slide I am taking example operation on CNC milling machine. First of all, we know that what is milling operation. Milling is a one type of machining operation by using multi-point cutter. That means for cutting operation, here we are using multi-point cutter for removing the material on workpiece or work part. That is the example operation on CNC milling operation. Milling means removing of material by using multi-point cutter. Here I am showing a part drawing about 1.8, that means 1 by 8 inch pocket. Middle is the pocket and outer side is the bracket. That means outer edge and inner edge. Here I am showing all the dimensions in inches. Material is 1020 steels. Steel 1 grade. Here in this X0, Y0, Z0, that indicates, previously I was told you about that. In usually we are talking about that in X0, Y0 in Cartesian coordinate system, that will be origin. That means that will be origin. But in CNC part programming, it is to be discussed as floating zero point. That means X0, Y0, Z0 indicates floating zero point. In this, 0.125 is the depth and it is the outer edge. It is the inner edge. That means pocket. Pocket edge, the countering operation, I'm taking the radius as 0.25. Next here, the depth will be 0.125. That is the depth, 0.125. In this, the distance is 0.375. This one is 2.75, then 0.75. After then, we want to produce any part by using CNC part programming. Firstly, we given the part program, part programming coding, NC codes to the machine control unit. After that, machine control unit, we are giving the NC codes or part programming by means of using G codes, M codes, N codes, and XYZ, IJK. Those are used for Cartesian coordinate axis system. N codes are used to identify the individual blocks. Next, G codes are usually used for dimensioning system. Next, M codes are used for some operations like start and stop operations. And auxiliary functions and auxiliary codes are used for some operations like coolant, off, on. Those are the auxiliary operations. We are regularly used in these codes like G codes, M codes, N codes, XYZ and IJK. IJK are not using in some operations. XYZ are commonly used codes in C and C part programming. First, G code programming. What is G code? We already know that about G codes are used to, and G codes are used for mentioning the dimensioning system. Here I am showing outer edge and inner edge. Inner edge will be pocket. Outer edge is the bracket. That means here I am showing 0.25 radius. I am giving 0.25 radius. Okay. In first pass, conventional mill to a depth of 0.125 around edge profile. It is the edge profile. That means here I am mentioning the depth. What I have to do now? 0.125 is the depth around edge. That means around edge. It is the radius. It is not depth. It is 0.25. It is the radius. 0.25 is the radius of pocket. Depth is, this is the depth. 0.125 is the depth. 0.25 is the radius of pocket. First of all, we want to produce any part or we want to make any part by using coding program. That means part programming. What is the difference between milling operation on manual method to part programming method? First of all, I'm taking manual method for producing a milling operation on work part. In manual method of producing work part on milling machine, in this milling machine, manually we are operating controls by using hand wheels, up feeding, down feeding, and rightward and leftward. Those are the controls by using manual feed. But in coming to CNC part programming, we are giving complete controls by using coding only. That means by using coding. First of all, initially we are giving the total complete information about movements, translations, etc., and spindle speed and feeding operation. Those are given firstly. That means starting operation of CNC part programming. First, we want to start any machine or any machining operation. We'll give total information to the machine control unit firstly. Then after, the machine will done all the operations. That means it do all the operations by using, we are given total data to the machine control unit. It is following our commands. That means our means operator commands. The main disadvantage of CNC part programming in this, the skilled persons are required. Okay, skilled persons are required to move the operation to forward. Next, in this first pass, conventional mill to a depth of 0.125 around edge profile. Tool one is half inch dia and end mill. In this, first of all, I'm giving coding. First of all, I am giving coding to the operation by means of following codes like N codes, M codes, and etc. In this, first of all, the code starts with percentage and then N5. N5 is the block number or sequence number. Previously, I was told you about that N codes are used for identifying the individual block number, N5. Next, G90. Previously, I was told you about that what is G code. And G codes are used in CNC part programming for mentioning dimensioning system. G90 code is used for absolute dimensioning. G91 is incremental dimensioning. And what is the difference between absolute dimensioning system to incremental dimensioning system? Absolute dimensioning system is the direct dimensioning system. That means it starts from origin. That means it is the machine tool. If for example, I am taking drilling operation. the drilling bit or drilling machine tool starts from origin, then it travels the distance from origin, then it will be calculated from starting operation. That means if the tool starts from 0 to 50, then the absolute dimensioning system to be mentioned, then the total length traveled in x direction is 50. If we are taking incremental dimensioning system, then if tool starts from 0 to 20, after then it stops, then it's taken some time, and then it starts from 20 to 50, then we are taking 20 to 50 difference between 20 to 50 is 30. 50 minus 20 is 30. In that case, we are taking 30 is the traveling distance in x direction. If we are taking incremental dimensioning system, it is the difference between absolute to incremental dimensioning system. Next, G20. G codes are all used for dimensioning system. G90 is absolute dimensioning system. First of all, we want to make or we want to produce any CNC part programming. We want to produce any part or work part using some operations. Here I am taking milling operation. It is your wish. You want to produce machining operation by using milling or drilling or shaping operation. Here I am taking milling operation. For that, first of all, we want to produce any or we want to make any part by using any machining operation. That means, first of all, you want to mention the dimensioning system after then starting operation manually or part programming method. Here I am taking part programming method, so I am giving the coding system to machine control unit. That means, first of all, block number, then dimensioning system, G90 absolute, G20 is the inches units. In this, I am mentioning all the units are inches, in inches. Next, N10, block number 10. After then, M06, it is the coding. M codes are used for starting or stopping operations in part programming. M06, it indicates tool changing number. That means tool changing operation, M06 is the tool changing operation. Then tool one, first of all, I'm taking tool one is the multiple tool cutter. That means it is used for removing the material from the work part. Tool changing number T1. I'm changing the tool here, T1. M06 is the tool changing number, tool changing operation. Next, N15, block number, M03. M03 is the spindle. M02 is used for machining operation. That means end, operation end. Next, operation end. M02 operation end. And coming to M03 indicates spindle on. That means after giving the tool changing to required operation, I am taking milling cutter here. T1 is the tool changing number. Then after giving certain tool or required tool, then it will be started by using of running the spindle. M03 is the spindle on in clockwise direction, not on anti-clockwise, clockwise direction. Then I am giving spindle speed. Spindle speed is the 1200 RPM. Spindle speed, S indicates spindle speed in 12,000 RPM. Then N20, Z00 is the rapid traverse. That means it is running with rapid, fast, in X direction 0.125. Previously, in the recent slide, I am discussing 0.125 is the depth of X direction. 0.125 depth of in Y direction also. Then in Z direction also 0.125. In all directions, I'm giving the depth as 0.125. Next, N35, Z01. Z01 means after giving certain depth here, 0.125. It is the depth. After then, I'm giving linear interpolation. Linear straight line interpolation between two points. It is called linear interpolation. Z01 is the linear interpolation. After it, travels 0.125 in z direction. It is x direction, it is y direction. After then, in z direction, it will be traveled in negative direction minus 0.125 depth. Speed rate is 5. F indicates speed rate is 5 inches. Then N40, x direction 3.875. Total length traveled in x direction 3.875. Total length traveled in y direction 4.125. And N50, x in x direction depth in y direction depth. 0.125. Next, in second pass, conventional mill to a depth of 0.25 around the edge profile. In this, I am giving countering operation by following a depth of 0.25. That means depth or radius as 0.25 around edge profile. It is the pocket or middle or center. It is the pocket. I am giving 0.25 as the depth or radius. Next, in first pass, I am giving 0.125 as the depth. It is the first pass. After then, giving 0.25 depth as per pocket. 0.25. For that operation, I am taking N35. Up to now, we are discussing about N55. Then, starting from N35, I am discussing the tool starts from linear interpolation. Then it is traveled in negative direction of 0.125. Feed rate will be 5. Then I am starting with that point N35Z minus 0.250. That means 0.125, 0.125. It will be minus 0.25. Then the distance will be 3.875, total distance traveled in x direction, in y direction 4.125. Then after the radius or the depth 0.125 in x direction, y direction, in z direction, total depth will be given to all centers in x, y, z directions. In third pass, conventional mill to a depth of 0.125 around pocket profile. In this inner surface of pocket, it is the bracket. Then in center, I am giving 0.125 depth. N65Z00 rapid traverse, reverse to original position. Then the x will be the total length. That means here I am giving the distance 0.125 in y direction 1. After the block number 70, Z01 is linear interpolation Z. First of all, it is traveled in negative direction in 0.125. Then it is reversed to original position Z minus 1.125. Feed rate will be 5 inches, N75. It is reversing to original position x1.75, y2.5, x1.25, n90, n95 distances. In fourth pass, climb mill to a depth of 0.25 across remaining material. In this, first of all, we are taking outer edge depth 0.125, then taking pocket outer edges 0.25 as radius depth. Next, middle center of pocket 0.125 as depth. Then in fourth pass, N100 y2.125 in y direction, it is traveled 2.125. It has to be traveled in 2.125. In x direction 2.625, z direction 0.125. Then Z00 reverse it to original position, starting from Z01 linear interpolation, starting from rapid travels and ends with rapid travels, return to original position x5, y5, z5, return to original position. Then M05 spindle off, N120 block number 120, M05 spindle off. Okay, then required milling operation is performed on pocket by following this procedure. Then M05 indicates the spindle stops, the spindle off or stops. Next, N125 indicates block number 85, M30 resets and restarts the program. Next, advanced features. Execution of the part of the program in a rotated or mirror position. That means final execution of the part or produced part in a rotated or mirror position. Next, scale the program and produce larger or smaller programs. That means change the scale dimensioning in any direction or larger or smaller. Then three-dimensional circular interpolation, which produces a helical shape. 3D, three-dimensional means, you know, we are taking in Cartesian coordinate axis system. In two-dimensional or three-dimensional, we are mentioning here three-dimensional circular interpolation, which produces a helical shape. Next, computer-aided part programming. NC program preparation may be tedious and difficult if the part to complex geometry. That means if the part has complex geometry, we want to mention the part programming by using skilled person knowledge. The main difficulty is to find out the cutter locations during the machining. Okay, in the machining operation, cutter location finding is very difficult. Why? Because we want to mention of adjacent linear interpolations and circular interpolation countering operations. Okay, those information will be given to the machine control unit by the operator. Computers may be used to assist the programmers in preparing the NC codes. Those are up to now we are discussing the parts or the codes of M code, G code, N code, then XYZ, IJK, FSTA. These are the NC codes, numerical control codes. Next, advantages of applying computer-aided part programming include the following. By following computer-aided part programming, it reduces the manual calculations involved in determining the geometric characteristics of the part. That means in manual method, we are doing all the calculations to produce a part. For that, for example, I am taking drilling operation. What is the depth to produce required part? What is the depth? What is the breadth? What is the width? What is the height? What is the rotation? That means those are the properties will be given in starting of the part. That means starting of the work part to required dimensions. By following NC codes or part programming method, we have to given all the codes or all the coding operations to the machine control unit by the operator. By following computer operations, it provides the cutter path simulations. It provides tool collision checking. That means tool failure operation will be checked by using computer-aided part programming. It makes the program preparation easier. The Aerospace Industries Association sponsored the work that led to the first part programming language developed in MIT in 1955. In Aerospace Industries Association sponsored the work. That means the first programming started by Aerospace Industries Association in 1955. After that, it is developed until now. This was called automatically programmed tool. Okay, APT is nothing but automatically programmed tools. Using the cutter location data, the program can generate the actual NC codes by using a post processor. Thank you all.